Hi, I'm Samuel L. Jackson, and this is my good friend, Abby.
Aww. And we're here to tell you the word of the day.
Today's word is belonging. Belonging is feeling like you're an important member of a group, like your family.
Oh, like how I belong in my family, because I'm a daughter and I'm a stepsister.
Yes, just like that. You're a very important part of your family, Abby.
Aw, thanks, Mr. Sam. But how would I know if I'm part of any other groups?
Good question, Abby. Mm-hmm. One way to know is to say I am and finish the sentence. For example, I am a friend.
Me too. I am a great friend.
And I am a neighbor who is part of my neighborhood.
What? Me too. I am a neighbor right here on Sesame Street. You know, I think I got this.
Let me try one.
Okay, my turn. I am a student.
Yes, you're a student, and students are very important members of a school.
Oh my goodness, I belong to a lot of groups.
You sure do. We all belong. We should all feel welcome and know there's a place for us.
Yeah. Mr. Sam, it's your turn.
You know, I do belong to a very special group. Huh? Here, I'll show you.
What?
Avengers Assemble!
What? The Avengers? Oh, I can't believe it. That is a very special group. You help so many people.
You know what, Abby? Huh? We're looking for a new member to join the group.
Mm-hmm. You are?
I am Incredibroccoli, the newest member of the Avengers.
Yes, you are, and you belong here.
Belonging!
Hey! Speak up. Use your voice. What is fair? Be kind. Use your heart. Show you care. Stand up. Use your mind. That's what we need. You can make the change that you want to see. You have the power and you know that you've got what it takes. Just keep on trying. You can always learn from your mistakes. There's work to do. Come together, one and all. Changemakers, lift us up. We stand tall. You've got a voice to use to help someone in need.
Yeah!
Changemakers, make the change. You've got great ideas. Just set them free. Changemakers, make the change. Strong heart, strong mind, strong on the inside. Stronger together, you and I. Speak up, use your voice. Work to do. All you really need is someone who can help you through. A real friend makes you feel like you belong. Be change makers and help each other feel strong. You've got a voice to use to help someone in need.
Yeah!
Change makers, make the change!
You've got great ideas, just set them free.
Whoa, whoa!
Change makers, make the change!
Lullaby called Kum Samari. It means three bears.
That's a beautiful song, Ji Young. How'd you learn that?
Thanks, Miss Eva. My harmony, that's my grandma. She helped me learn it. She would sing it to me when I was a baby.
But Emma really likes your song too, Ji Young.
Thanks.
Do you want to show us something that you've learned, Elmo?
Well, maybe. look. Elmo learned to write his name. See, it says E-L-M. That's Elmo.
Yeah, that's your name, all right.
Yeah.
Great job, Elmo. I'm so proud of both of you.
Yeah.
Oh, hi. I'm Ava, and I'm here with my friends, Ji Young and Elmo.
Hello.
We were just having share and tell. Now it's time to share and tell today's word of the day.
Ooh. What's today's word, Miss Ava? Elmo can't wait. What's today's word?
The word of the day is proud.
Miss Ava? Mm-hmm. What does proud mean?
Well, let's see. How did you feel, Elmo, when you learned to write your name?
Yeah, Elmo was happy that he learned how to write his name.
And how did you feel when you learned to play Three Bears on your guitar, Ji-young?
Well, I felt really good about myself.
You both felt proud. Proud is when you feel really good about who you are and something that you did or something someone else did.
Wow. What are you proud of, Miss Ava?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, so many things. I'm proud of being a writer and a director. Mm. I get to write and tell stories about interesting people. Mm. And you know what? I'm proud of the two of you.
Wow, that's really nice.
We all have so much to be proud of.
We do. We do. Be proud of who you are and what you can do.
That's right. Oh, yeah.
No, I want one, too. I'm proud of you, Miss Ava.
Yeah.
Aw, thanks.
Let's celebrate Black History.
Yippee, yippee. So much to celebrate and see.
Yippee, yippee. I'm proud of who I am and who I'm gonna be.
On the road, traffic lights help cars move safely.
Did you know it was made by an African American just like me? Let's go, go, go!
We can soar in the clouds way up high. Did you know?
History.
Yippee, yippee. So much to celebrate and see.
Yippee, yippee. I'm proud of who I am and who I'm gonna be.
We're making history every day.
In science, education, and the sports we play.
We can be anything we wanna be.
Tamir and Gabrielle are gonna make history.
I can be a chef who loves to bake.
Or an inventor. What will I make?
I can be a musician who loves to play.
I can be a firefighter who saves the day.
You can make history too.
I'm Amanda.
I'm Gabrielle.
And I am both out of breath and very late. I am so sorry.
Hi, Grover. We were just about to share the word of the day with everyone.
Oh, do not worry. I will handle this, Amanda. Today's word is
Today's word is upstander.
Upstander is an important word.
Yes, it is, because being an upstander means you are done sitting down. Yes.
No.
No. No. Oh, right! An upstander is the little flippy thingy on your bicycle.
That's a kickstand, Grover.
Are you sure? I am pretty good with words, Amanda.
I am sure. And hey, being an upstander
means standing on your tippy toes as tall as you can. Whoa!
Grover, that's still not it.
It is not?
Mm-mm.
An upstander is someone who uses their kind words or actions to help their friends or themselves when they are being treated unfairly and unkindly.
Treated unfairly and unkindly?
Sometimes people are treated unfairly because of the color of their skin, the shape of their eyes, the language they speak, or because of their religion.
An upstander treats everyone with kindness, fairness, and respect.
So, if someone were to say something unkind to you, Amanda, or you, Gabrielle, about your brown skin, I would say, that is wrong, and all skin is beautiful.
That's being an upstander, Grover.
And if someone says I can't play with them because of the way I look, I can be an upstander for myself and tell them that's wrong and not fair.
Sure, we can all play together.
Those are great examples of being an upstander for yourself and others. Thank you to all the upstanders out there.
Yes, thank you.
I'm Tamir, and this is my show where we ask important questions to learn about our neighborhood. Welcome to Tamir on the Streets. Bop-bop-a-da-bop-bop, Tamir. Bop-bop-a-da-bop-bop, my show. Giving me a hand on the show are my helping hands. Yeah, oh, nice. Thank you. Very helpful. Thank you. All right. Today's show is about answering the question, what does it mean to believe in yourself? Well, believing in yourself is when we are proud of who we are and what we can do. Oh, hey. Well, let's see how you can believe in yourself when playing a sport. Oh, come on. I'll be right there.
Oh, thanks.
Hi, Jiyoung.
Hi, Tamir. Oh, hi, everybody.
Thanks for joining us on Tamir on the Street. Yeah. What sport are you going to show us?
Well, I brought my awesome skateboard.
Whoa, cool. Was it easy learning how to ride it?
Oh, it was really hard at first. Come on, Jiyoung. I didn't give up, even when it was really hard. I practiced and practiced, and I believed in myself and knew I could be a great skateboarder.
Wow. Believing in yourself means never giving up. Now, Jiyoung is going to show us what happens when you keep practicing.
Yeah, go ahead, go ahead. Check this out. Nah. Huh.
Okay, she's on a board. She slides along. Wow, look at her go. Great job, Jiyoung. Way to believe in yourself and not give up. A paintbrush. I wonder how we can believe in ourselves with a paintbrush. Let's go. Oh, there we go. That's it. Yes. Thanks.
Dum de dum dum dum. Dum de dum dum.
Oh, hi, Cookie Monster. Hi, Charlie.
Hi, Tamir.
What are you two painting?
Oh, we painting these pretty flowers. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But in our own special way.
In your own special way?
Yeah. Me painted cookie flower. Me see cookie and everything.
And I painted my flowers using triangle shapes.
Oh, boy. Me love those triangle-y flowers, Charlie.
Yeah, me too. You both created flowers in your own special way.
Yeah.
How does that make you feel?
Proud. I'm proud of my painting because I did it my way.
Yeah. And me believe in me-self. Yeah. And, me also believe these cookie flowers look delicious. Mwah! Cookie flower! Now that what me call art appreciation. Yeah.
Being proud and doing things in your own special way is a great example of believing yourself. Thanks, Charlie. Thanks, Cookie Monster.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
It was great seeing so many people who believe in themselves. Mm-hmm. Jiyoung believed in herself and learned how to ride a skateboard. And Cookie Monster and Charlie believed in themselves by creating art in their own special style. You know, I believed in myself too. I always wanted to have my own show. And here we are at the end of our very first episode.
Yeah.
And I couldn't have done it without you. I want to thank our guests for believing in themselves. You are all amazing. Tune in next time for more
Tamir on the Street.
I'm so proud of you, Tamir.
Thanks.
Hi, I'm Anna, and I'm here with my friends Big Bird and Ji Young.
Hello there.
Hi.
We're here to tell you the word of the day.
Oh, Anna, what's today's word?
Today's word is unique. It means one of a kind. It's something that's very special.
The old lady moo. Was that unique, Anna?
I'd say a yodeling cow is definitely unique.
And amazing.
Oh, yeah. You know, each of us is unique, too.
Really?
Yeah. What we like, where we come from, how we speak, and how we look, all of that makes us unique.
Hey, Big Bird, you sure are unique. I've never met a bird like you. And you have the brightest yellow feathers I've ever seen.
Gee, thanks, Ji Young. You're unique, too. Yeah, you can rock out on the electric guitar, and you have a really neat vest with a lot of patches on it.
Yeah, thanks, Big Bird. These patches show all the things that are special to me.
And that makes your vest unique, too.
Yeah. Oh, you know, Anna, you're unique.
You think so?
Yeah, you got the coolest glasses I've ever seen.
Why, thank you.
And no one dances like you.
I do have some pretty unique
and awesome
dance moves.
Wow.
You are unique too.
Yes, you are.
So let's celebrate what makes us and others unique, one of a kind and special.
Wow.
Yeah. Ooh. Anna, show me some of those unique moves.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, let's dance till the cow goes home.
What does it take for us to be upstanders?
An upstander.
An upstander is a person who speaks and acts kind.
No matter who you are, they'll do what's right.
Using their voices to help people who are treated unfairly. Upstanders are all around and they're easy to find. So let's all be
upstanders.
Others how they want to be treated. Love and respect, yeah, everybody needs it.
It's not easy to do, but you can do it too.
We are not afraid, we will let you know. What you did's not fair, we're all saying no.
Upstander.
No matter who you are, they'll do us right.
Upstander.
Everyone is special in their own way. Let's show love and kindness today.
Yeah.
Let's all be fair,
yes.
And stand up for our friends because we care.
Upstander
is someone who cheers you on. If you agree, sing the upstander song.
Upstander,
we'll show you how to do it. Yeah. You should treat others how they want to be treated. Love and respect, yeah, everybody needs it.
Upstander, it's not easy to do, but you can do it too.
We are not afraid, we will let you know. What you did's not fair, we're all saying no.
Upstander.
Hi, I'm Gabrielle Union.
And I am your cute and lovable pal, Grover.
We are here to share the word of the day. The word of the day is...
Unity! Oh, sorry, I was just so excited about the word of the day, Miss Gabrielle Union.
I am too, Grover. Do you want to explain unity to everyone?
Oh, yes, thank you very much. Okay, unity is... Okay, so you have the U, and then you have the T, and, I do not know how to explain it, Miss Gabrielle Union.
Here, let me help. Unity is when we play, work, and come together. You see, uni means one.
Oh, right, yes, you need the visual, yes, excuse me. Be right back.
Uni means one, like me here all alone. But unity is when we bring everyone together.
Okay, that's your cue. Come on in, everybody. You too, Birdie.
Okay. Hello there.
Hey. Hi, everyone. Thank you for joining us and showing us unity. There's lots of examples of unity.
Like when we come together as a family.
Bring it in, cuz.
Yeah. That's
adorable.
And a form of unity.
Or when we play sports with our friends. That's
really fun.
And a great example of unity. Coming together as a family, a classroom, friends, or even a community like here on Sesame Street is...
beautiful.
Unity.
Ah, yes, yes, that too.
Okay, now let's unite for a...
cheeseburger!
group hug.
So that is a no on the cheeseburger then?
Kind words go a very long way. They make us feel much closer. Like, thank you. And do you want to play? I'll invite you over. I'll save a seat for you when you need one. And if you're sad, I'll listen too until the sadness is done. La, 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 la. We shine together. La, 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 la. Friends that always give you courage, hold your hand. When they see that you need help, now together we can. Be kind to all the others we see. 'Cause it's not just you or me, it's we. A kind act can make someone's day. So I'll be a good neighbor and tilt the umbrella your way to keep you dry and safer. I'll always be by your side in any weather. We won't let our feelings hide because we're better together. La, 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 la. We shine much brighter. La, 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 la. Friends that always give you courage, hold your hand. When they see that you need help, not together we can. Be kind to all the others we see. 'Cause it's not just you or me, it's we.
Aloha, I'm Jacob.
Aloha, that's how people greet each other in Hawaii.
That's right, Big Bird. And it's the perfect word to help us introduce the word of the day.
Well, what is today's word, Jacob?
Culture. Culture is what we share with a group of people, including our family, friends, and community.
Well, we're friends, Jacob. What can we share with each other?
We can share a lot. Culture is our beliefs and traditions, language, and celebrations.
So, culture is who we are and what makes us special.
That's right. I'm a Filipino-American, and my family's from the Philippines, and I grew up in Hawaii.
Well, I grew up here on Sesame Street with my Granny Bird. And you know, my Auntie Bird is from Hawaii, just like you.
Oh, so that's why you know what aloha means.
Mm-hmm.
Language is an important part of culture.
Well, what other parts of your culture are there, Jacob?
Well, a big part of my culture is the stories we tell, and we do that through dance.
Like the hula.
That's right. Did your auntie teach you that too?
She did.
Well, the hula is a traditional Hawaiian dance. My family also dances the tinikling, which is a Filipino dance. Dance is important to both of my cultures.
Wow. I love learning about your culture, Jacob.
Well, I have one more thing to share with you from my culture.
Hmm?
My Lola, my grandma, says that whenever we visit someone, we should always bring a gift.
A gift? For me?
This is called ube pandesal. It's a traditional Filipino snack.
Wow. Thank you, Jacob. You know, an important part of my family's culture is sharing with my friends.
Aw.
I bet Cookie Monster would love this.
I'm sure he would. Oscar, too?
Does it have sardines in it?
No.
Probably not. Looks yummy.
Today we're answering the question. What are ways we can use breathing to help us feel calm when we're, you know, feeling angry or frustrated or excited? Whoa! A volcano! Cool. Uh-oh. Oh, come on, let's learn more about peaceful breathing before it explodes! Wow! Oh.
Hey.
What's wrong, Ji-young?
Hi, Tamir.
What's going on?
You ever feel frustrated? You know, when you have really big feelings like you're an exploding volcano?
A volcano? Ji-young, we can do volcano breaths to help you calm down. That's when we let our breath explode out with our big feelings.
Yeah. Okay.
Everyone start with your hands together in front of you.
Okay.
Yeah, just like that. There you go. Okay, take a deep breath in, raising your hands. Good. Then let your breath explode out like a volcano. Oh, nice. Well, let's try that again, but this time you lead, Ji-young.
Okay, put your hands together in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay, take a deep breath in.
Yes.
While raising your hands.
Yeah.
Your breath explodes like a volcano!
I know you're feeling frustrated, Ji-young, but how do you feel after doing some volcano breaths?
Well, I feel a lot better, Tamir. Thanks!
That's great. Numbers. Let's see how these numbers can help us calm down when we feel angry or frustrated. Come on! Oh, it's right there. I just had to stop and take a quick breath. Okay, I'm good. Oh, hi, Grover.
Hello, Tamir.
What are you doing, Grover?
Oh, I am practicing 4-7-8 breathing.
4-7-8 breathing?
Yes. I use it whenever I am feeling upset or angry, and it helps me calm down.
Oh, well, can you show us, Grover?
Of course. But we will need somebody to demonstrate. Where will we find somebody to demonstrate?
I'm right here. I could, demonstrate.
Sold! You have got the job.
Yes.
Now let us begin.
Okay.
Take a deep breath in for 4 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now hold it for 7 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And breathe out for 8 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ah! Great job! Let us do that again. Now, this time, you lead the 4-7-8 breathing, Tamir.
Oh, okay. And you'll demonstrate?
I am the monster for the job!
Okay, great. Okay. Take a deep breath in for 4 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now hold it for 7 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Now breathe out for 8 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, thanks, Grover. I feel peaceful and calm after that breathing exercise.
Oh, that is wonderful, Tamir.
Thanks. I gotta go.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Looks like everything is calm here at Tamir on the Street. Today, Ji-young learned that one exercise we can use when we have big feelings is volcano breathing. Oh, and Grover taught us that we can use 4-7-8 breathing when we feel angry or upset. You know, I'm feeling peaceful and calm after a great show with all my friends. See you next time on Tamir on the Street! Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, that's good.
Hi, I'm Zassi. Today we're cleaning up the garden before we share the word of the day.
Yeah. Zassi, is it time for the word of the day now?
Yeah, because the garden is so nice and clean.
Yeah, it is really clean. Okay, today's word of the day is respect. Does anyone know what respect means?
I know what that word means.
I've heard that word before. And
okay,
I know what that
I'm so glad you're all excited about the word respect, but how about we take turns listening to each other?
Okay.
Well, who would like to go first?
Pretty please.
All right, Abby, how about you?
Okay, well, we show respect when we treat each other with kindness.
Well, the Honker and Dinger agree.
Oh, yeah, me too. Oh, and respect is also when you treat others the way they want to be treated.
Right, again. And we're all showing respect right now by listening to each other and taking turns.
Yeah.
Oh, and by cleaning up the garden.
Yeah, we're showing nature and Sesame Street respect by keeping the garden clean.
Yes, we are. Thank you all for respecting the garden and each other. Aww. Our words, actions, and feelings are all ways we can show respect. Mm-hmm. And do you know the most important thing?
We all deserve respect.
Yep. Now we can show respect to Oscar the Grouch by giving him all these mucky leaves.
That's a great idea.
I think there's some more down here.
We gotta
here.
Get some more for
oh,
sure.
Yeah,
oh, there's some over there.
Diwali, Diwali, it's a festival of light. Diwali, Diwali, shine happy and bright. Diwali, Diwali, it's a festival of light. Diwali, Diwali, shine happy and bright. So come on everybody, join in and shine, shine bright. Together the fun really begins when we shine, shine bright. Together!
Opening our hearts.
So come on everybody, join in and shine, shine bright. Together the fun really begins when we shine, shine bright. Together! We're so grateful you're all here to celebrate with us and cheer Shubh Diwali.
Happy Diwali.
Shubh Diwali. Shubh Diwali.
Diwali, Diwali, for 5 days and nights. Diwali, Diwali, it's the festival of life.
Hello there. Tamir and I are baking cookies.
Oh, wow. Those look great. I had no idea you like to bake.
I do. It relaxes me. We're also here to tell you the word of the day.
Ooh, today's word begins with the letter F.
Oh, I love the letter F.
Today's word is... No, that's a drum roll.
That's very nice.
Thank you. Fairness.
Fairness is when each of us gets what we need.
Me need cookie, please.
Whoa. You know, it is fair when we share.
Yeah.
You're right. Cookie, why don't you try one?
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Ha ha ha. Cookie! Ah, nom, 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 nom.
What's another way that we can be fair?
When we play soccer later, we can make sure everyone gets a turn and invite others to play with us.
That's right. We can be fair by inviting everyone to play soccer. But first, we need to clean up.
Me can help clean up.
Thanks, Cookie Monster. You're showing fairness by doing your part and helping others.
Yeah, yeah, me, Cookie Monster, but me also, Fair Monster. Tamir?
Yeah.
Me wash. If you dry.
Ooh, sounds fair to me.
Right, now, our team's for soccer.
Oh,
right. I think it would be fair if...
Me the captain. Yeah, good idea. Yeah, me like that. You know, me the best player after all.
Oh, really?
Oh.
Well, let's see your footwork.
Oh, yeah.
That's beautiful.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, yeah, here, watch this.
Pretty good.
Thank you.
All right, fair enough. You're the captain.
Okay, good.
Take yourself for a walk. The grass on your feet in the spring and summer feels very neat. On your walk, smell the flowers blooming by the path. They smell so good during their morning sun bath. Joy with every step we take, with every step we take. On your walk, feel the sun shining bright on your face. Its warmth is like a hug from this beautiful place. Hear the wind blowing softly as it rustles the leaves. Bees buzz around the flowers and float
for a break. We feel calm, we feel joy with every step we take. With every step we take. On your walk, see a bird singing their song. Listen to them sing and follow along. And as our walk ends, the good feelings will stay. So let's thank the outdoors for an amazing day. A walk with nature is a wonderful moment for a break. A moment for a break. We feel calm, we feel joy. Every step we take, a moment for a break, a moment for a break. With every step we take, with every step we take, a moment for a break. With every step we take, a moment for a break.
Hi, I'm Amanda, and I'm with my good friends, Bert and Ernie, to tell you about a very important word.
Oh, that's right, Amanda. The word of the day is voice.
And we use our voice to express ourselves in all sorts of ways. We can use our voice to sing.
Craw.
La.
Ha.
Ow.
That was your turn, Bert.
Yeah, I know, Ernie.
We can use our voice for poetry.
Roses are red.
Violets are blue.
That was your turn again, Bert.
I know, Ernie.
We can also use our voice to express how we are feeling.
Yeah? Well, I'm feeling a bit nervous.
It's okay to feel nervous, Bert. We can also use our voices to help support others.
Oh, right. You can do this, Bert. I believe in you.
But Ernie, what if I sing a tra instead of a la? Or what if my poem doesn't rhyme?
I have an idea. Why don't we all sing and say the poem at the same time? Our voices are stronger together.
Great,
guess
okay,
we can do this.
Tra, la, la.
Roses are red, violets are blue. If you were a flower, I pick you!
Hey, that wasn't so bad!
Way to use your voice, Bert!
Thank you!
If we come together, we can help make all our voices heard. How will you use your voice?
Well, I'm going to use my voice to thank my friends for helping me! Thank you!
Aw, you're welcome, Bert. Hey, you know what? I'm going to use my voice to ask for a big hug. Can I have a big hug?
Sure.
Oh, group hug.
Aww. Yeah.
That's nice.
Today's show is all about answering the question, how can we be a good friend? Well, a good friend is someone you care about. Oh, and here, I got you something. It's a friendship bracelet. Yeah, because I care about you. Oh, nice. Oh, you're welcome. Oh, a book. And a paintbrush. How can you be a good friend with a paintbrush and a book? Let's find out together. That bracelet looks great on you, by the way. Yeah. Oh. Hey, looks like we found what the book and paintbrush are for. It's a play date with Baby Bear and Zoe.
Hi, Tamiyo.
That is correct, Tamiyo. There's just one wee little problem.
Yeah, I want us to make something with these arts and crafts supplies.
Yeah, and I want to act out a story about pirates from this book. Such a conundrum.
Yeah. Looks like you both want to do something different. How can we be good friends and solve this problem? Oh, this is a head-scratcher.
I'll say.
Hey! Why don't we do both?
Both?
Yeah. We can make outs and crafts and use them to act out a story.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, wait, look. This paper towel tube can be a telescope for a story about two best friend pirates.
Aug, matey. I like the sound of that.
Yeah.
Good friends care about each other. One way to show you care is by listening to each other and working together. Oh, a soccer ball. Let's see how we can be a good friend when we play games and sports. Come on, matey. Here we go.
Bye, Tabby. Arr.
Oh,
whew. Whoa. Here we go. Hey, looks like Grover's playing soccer.
Yes. I, your cute and sporty Grover, am an expert at playing soccer. Oh, I will get it. Be right back.
Oh, hey, Tamir.
Hi, Jian.
Have you seen my soccer ball? I can't find it anywhere. Hey! Is that my soccer ball, Grover?
Oh, yes. It is your cute and well-inflated soccer ball.
Did you ask to borrow it, Grover? I was gonna play with it.
Oh, I did not. I asked the last time I used it, but I did not ask this time.
You should always ask your friends when you want to play with their toys, Grover.
Oh, I am so sorry. You are right. I should have asked you first. Here you go.
Oh, thanks, Grover. It's okay.
You both worked through a problem with kindness and understanding. And you showed us how to be a good friend.
Oh, hey, Grover.
Yes?
Well, you want to play soccer.
Mm-hmm.
I want to play soccer. Mm-hmm. Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Are you thinking we could use a watermelon as a soccer ball?
But no, I was thinking we could play together.
Oh, that is even better. Yes, yes.
Oh. Great idea. Have fun, you two. Well, sharing is another great example of friendship.
Heads up!
Whoa! Whoa! Helping hands and helping feet. What a great show with all my friends. Zoe and Baby Bear showed us how to be good friends by listening to each other and working together. Oh, and Chiyoung and Grover showed us how you can work through a problem with kindness and understanding.
And do not forget sharing.
Yeah, we had a ball playing soccer together.
Oh, I want to thank our friends for showing us how to be good friends today. Mm-hmm. It's great to have friends like you.
Aww.
Especially you. You are the best. And see you next time for more
Tamir on the Street!
Hi, I'm Jill Biden, and I'm here with my good friend, Gabrielle.
Hi, we're here to tell you the word of the day.
Today's word is kindness. It means doing something to show you care about people, animals, or the environment.
There's lots of ways you can show kindness.
Oh, hi!
Gabrielle, hi! Elmo and Tango made you a picture.
Wow, this is beautiful. It's also a great example of kindness. You showed that you care about Gabrielle and me by making this drawing.
Yeah, thanks, Elmo and Tango. And look, I've got something for Tango right here.
Tango loves to play fetch.
Good girl, Tango. Playing with and taking care of animals is another great example of kindness.
Yeah. Where are you going, Tango?
Tango bought a watering can to water the plants and flowers.
That's very kind of you, Tango.
It is. When we do things for others, it makes us feel good, too. It's important that we are kind to every person, monster, animal, and the environment. And yes, puppies, too.
Looks like Tango wants to keep playing fetch.
Well, let's keep playing and show Tango some more
kindness.
Show me flamenco, and I can show you hip.
special to show. When we come together, we find new ways to grow. When we share what makes us special, we can all be friends. When we learn from one another, we can all be friends. We can learn to say friend in different ways. In any language, it still means we like to share and play. You can say 朋友. You can say 阿迪卡. You can say 阿米哥. You can say 乌拿里伊. We can come together and share our special foods, like empanadas or dumplings. They all taste so good. We make music using different sounds, like the bassoon or clave or a sitar or a silver flute. We can share our different flavors and styles to create something beautiful that makes us smile. We can share our different voices and sing along. When our band plays together, we can make a new song. When we share what makes us special, we can all be friends. When we love from one another, we can all be friends. When we share what makes us special, we can all be friends. When we love from one another, we can all be friends.
Oh, yay! That was wonderful!
Oh, thank you. Our family has been doing this hula for a very long time. It's called the Friendship Hula, and it's full of love and aloha.
Mm-hmm. We dance it whenever a special friend visits. A friend like you, Zahn.
Oh, I'm honored, Big Bird and Nani Bird. It's such a wonderful family tradition.
Tradition?
Yes, tradition. And you know, tradition happens to be today's word of the day. Traditions are special things we do that are passed down from person to person in our family.
Like you teaching me the friendship hula, Auntie Nani Bird? Is that a tradition?
Oh, exactly, my Manunui.
Ah, do you have any family traditions, Don?
Yes, I'm a member of the Lakota tribe, and a special tradition in my family is my grandparents make dried elk meat. Ooh. And they call it bapa, and they send it to us every year at Christmas.
Wow. That sounds like a great tradition.
Oh, you know, Manunui, we have a tradition like that.
Birdseed birthday cupcakes.
Oh, that sounds like a delicious tradition. You know, another tradition in my family is we give everyone a Lakota name. I have a twin brother, and I was the first born, so my Lakota name is Tokahiaku, which means the first to come.
Aww. That's beautiful, Zahn.
There are so many wonderful traditions and special moments for all of us to celebrate.
Oh, Zahn, I have a new tradition.
You do?
Uh-huh. From now on, whenever we say goodbye to each other, we'll share a big hug.
Oh. Mm-hmm. I love this tradition. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know, in my culture, we don't say goodbye. Hmm? We say doksha, which means I will see you soon.
Hmm. Doksha!
See you soon!
I strum on my guitar. Notes travel near and far. I'll play a song that's new. A song about me and you.
Celebrate me, celebrate you, everything we are and love to do.
Every day you make us proud.
Sing it proud and sing it loud.
Todos juntos all together.
Vamos juntos a cantar.
I hear the music of your guitarra. My feet move, ven y baila. Together let us move and sway. I love merengue, salsa and bachata.
Everything we are and love to do.
Every day you make us proud.
Sing it proud and sing it loud.
Todos juntos all together.
Vamos juntos a bailar.
When you rest your feet, I made a special treat. Mi familia loves to cook. Yummy chipas. Have a look.
Gracias. Nom 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 nom.
Celebrate me, celebrate you. Everything we are and love to do.
Every day.
sung for mis amigos,
mi pana, and my friends.
Together our celebration never ends.
Celebrate me, celebrate you, everything we are and love to do. Celebrate me, celebrate you, everything we are and love to do.
Celebrate today and every day, mis queridos amigos latinos.
Oh, hi, I'm Rosie. I'm getting ready to go skating with Grover.
Oh.
Yeah. Here he comes now.
Yeah, hello, Rosie. It is I, your cute and adorable roller skate missing monster, Grover.
Roller skate missing?
Yes, yes, you see, this foot has a roller skate, see?
That's a roller skate, all right.
Yes, it is. Yeah. But this foot, it does not have a roller skate, see? Whoa, whoa, ow!
Oh, Grover! Oh. Are you okay?
No, I am not okay! How can we go skating when I am missing a roller skate? You cannot skate without a roller skate. It is right there in the name. Oh, I am so very, very, very upset.
You know, I think today's word of the day could help a lot. Mm-hmm. The word of the day is resilience.
Oh, resilience! Great! What does resilience mean?
Resilience is when we have strength on the inside and are able to move on when things are unfair or go wrong.
Oh, you mean like when you only have one roller skate?
Exactly. We had a plan to skate together, but it didn't work out.
Ah, but I can have resilience?
That's right. You can be resilient and move on. So, don't let the fact that you don't have roller skates stop you from having fun, all right? Hey, how about this? Let's do something where we don't need roller skates.
What?
Like jogging.
Oh, jogging! I will be right back! I love jogging! Follow me, Rosie!
Now that's resilience. Slow down, Grover! Wait for me!
Today's show is all about answering the question... Oh, hi. What are our friends' family traditions? Well, a tradition is when we pass down something special, like a favorite food or custom or belief from person to person in our family. Oh, a plate. What does a plate have to do with family traditions? Let's find out. Oh, hi. Oh, let's go. Let's go. Oh, hi, Cookie Monster. Hi, Charlie.
Hi, Demeter.
Oh, something smells good.
Yeah, I just taught Cookie Monster how to make challah. Challah is a special bread I've every Friday night with my family as part of our Jewish tradition.
Oh, that's just like cookie for me family. Though we have those every day. Hour. Sometimes minute.
Hey, Cookie Monster, can you share your family's cookie recipe with me? Just like I shared my challah recipe.
Me like the sound of that.
Those sound like great family traditions. Food is an important part of family traditions. Oh, it reminds me, every Sunday, we have my great-grandpa Zizi's triple cheesy macaroni. Yeah.
Want to know the best part about these traditions?
They taste delicious.
Yeah.
And we look forward to making them with our families every week. Now, let's dig in.
Challah!
Wow, that was one yummy tradition. Thanks for sharing, Charlie. Music. Oh, come on. Let's see how music can be a family tradition. Oh, bye, Cookie. Bye, Charlie.
Bye, come here.
Oh, go ahead, Eric. Oh, nice. Thank you. Oh, onward! Oh, that's why we had the musical notes. Hi, Wes.
Oh, hi, Demir.
Oh, that sounds great. Oh,
thanks. I've been practicing my steel drum a lot.
Oh. Can you tell us about your steel drum and why you like to play it?
Oh, my mom told me about the steel drum. She even made my drum for me.
She made your drum?
Yeah, my grandparents are from Trinidad, and when my mom would visit them, she'd listen to her neighbors play the steel drum. Oh, she loved it so much that she made a drum so I can play my Trinidadian music for everyone on Sesame Street.
Wow, Your mom passed down her love of music to you. Music is another great family tradition.
Every time I play my drum, I think of my family.
Music reminds me of my family, too. I have a drumstick from my great-grandfather.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah, check this out. Yeah. Every time I play it, I feel like he's right there with me. Thanks for sharing your family tradition with us, Wes. All right, play me out.
What a great show. We learned all about different family traditions. We learned about the special bread called challah that Charlie's family makes every week. And we learned how Wes's mom passed down her love of Trinidadian music to Wes. Thanks for celebrating families with us today. I know my family's watching, so big shout out to Mom and Dad and Grandma Nell and Gabrielle. All right, we'll see you next time on
Tamir on the Street.
Look around us, we can be inspired by so much. A lot of great ideas to think of, and many more great things to dream of. In life, there's everyday people doing things that matter. Just like my neighbor from down the street, because she teaches kids to read. Trust that you can really be inspired. And with dedication, we can achieve much more than one could dream. If I could see it, I believe it, I can be it and achieve it. It's great seeing the different things others do. It makes me reach for my dreams. Embrace what's special about you, like singing a song or gotten into. Maybe it's a nurse that inspires you, or a business owner because they love what they do. First to try something new, or watch someone great, see how they do what they do. So many things that inspire you can inspire others too. Trust that you can really be inspired. And with dedication, you can achieve much more than you could dream. If I can see it, I believe it, I can be it and achieve it. I feel great seeing you do things too. Now reach for your dreams. Embrace the things that's special about you, like riding a bike or baking cookies do. Creative things only if you knew. People may see you and want to do what you do. Be the first to try something new, or watch someone great, see how they do what they do. I'll let you know it's not impossible. It all begins with you. Upstanders, yeah. Scientists, yeah. Firefighters, yeah. Teacher, a veterinarian, yeah. Artist, or in politics like the president, yeah. Mechanic, yeah. Families because they really care, yeah. A good neighbor that's really kind, yeah. The choice is up to you.
Hi, I'm Troy.
Greetings,
Hi, Troy. Hi, Troy.
I'm deaf, and I use American Sign Language to communicate.
Oh, but I don't know any American Sign Language.
Me either. How will you know what we are saying?
Don't worry. This is my friend, Xavier. Xavier will sign to me what you are saying so we can all communicate together.
Oh, that is wonderful!
There are so many ways we can communicate.
You know, today's word of the day is all about that. The word of the day is diversity. This is how you sign diversity. Sign it with me.
Diversity.
Diversity.
Yeah. What does diversity mean, Senor Troy?
Diversity is understanding and appreciating our differences. Differences in the way we look, where we are from, and how we communicate.
Ah, all the things that makes us who we are.
That's right.
Well, part of what makes me who I am is that I'm from Transylvania, I have fangs, and I love to count.
See? And I'm a monster. And I'm from Mexico. Y hablamos español and we speak Spanish. Yeah? Mm-hmm.
Yes, those are all the important things that make you who you are.
What makes you who you are, Señor Troy?
Well, my family is from the Czech Republic. I'm an actor, and I'm deaf.
Amazing. We are all different in lots of ways.
That's diversity.
Diversity.
But one thing that we all have in common is that we are all friends. Sign it with me. Friends. Friends.
Friends. Friends. Yeah, we are all friends.
Friends.
Jesse, they're even more family we found.
Love makes a family. My family is part of me. Love makes us proud of who we are. Love makes a family. My family is part of me. Love makes us proud of who we are. I'm proud of who I am.
Soccer game,
driving with my papas and my piblings.
I love my sibling.
They take